Hi friends, in this video we are going to see the new technique to simplify and solve a problem, and it is called as Norton's theorem. So let's see what the statement of Norton's theorem is saying. It states that it is possible to simplify any complex linear circuit to an equivalent circuit with just a single current source and a parallel resistance connected to a load, where current is called as Norton's current, which is obtained between the terminals where load is connected after replacing load by a short circuit link, and a value of resistance, which is also called as Norton's resistance, is obtained by removing load resistance and replacing all the power sources by their internal resistances. So what is the important thing here you have to understand is how to get this Norton's current. The procedure to get a Norton's current is we have to replace load by a short circuit link. That means we have to remove RL and we have to place a wire between the terminals where load resistance was connected and Norton's resistance is obtained. First of all, we have to remove load, and then all the power sources we need to replace with their internal resistances. So if you see properly, the second part of Norton's theorem is same as second part of Thevenin's theorem. So there is absolute similarity between how to find out Norton's resistance and Thevenin's resistance. Only difference is how to get this Norton current. To elaborate this concept, let's take a simple problem and solve it by a Norton's theorem. So I will consider a circuit with voltage sources and three resistances connected like this. I will consider this is V1, this is V2, R1, R2, and let's consider this as load resistance RL, through which we are supposed to find out a current using Norton's theorem. So objective is to get IL using Norton's theorem. So it is saying four steps. First step is a calculation of IN, which we call as Norton's current, calculation of IN. For this, as per the theorem, you will get Norton's current if you replace load by a short circuit link. See the modification that we are supposed to make while calculating IN. Instead of this RL, I will have a short circuit link like this, and rest of the part of the circuit will be same. So I will get this circuit with V1, V2 acting, R1, R2 will remain as it is. Only thing is that RL we replaced by short circuit, so that I will get part between A and B shorted having current IN. To get this IN, you can use any of the technique, either a circuit reduction technique by source transformation or nodal analysis or mesh analysis. My advice, and we will see this through certain problems, whenever you solve a problem of a Norton's theorem, while calculating IN, preferably go for mesh analysis. I will elaborate this concept at the time of solving numericals also. So find IN by using mesh analysis. So once we got iron, we can move ahead with the second step, and that is calculation of Rn. So how to get Rn, which is a Norton's resistance? We need to remove load. Remove means we have to open circuit it, and all the power sources, voltage source and current source, need to be replaced by their internal resistances. So for calculation of Rn, three things we have to remember. What are those? First, we have to remove RL. Let's not confuse ourselves. Here, while calculating Rn, what I have done, RL I have replaced with a short circuit. So I should write over here, RL is short circuited. And for calculation of Rn, I am saying remove RL. That means I will open circuit RL. What about the sources? Here we are having two voltage sources. Being a voltage source, its internal resistance is zero. So voltage sources should be replaced by zero resistance, which is short circuit. So voltage sources are short circuited. Though here we are not having a current source, but still in general, if current source is present, that we need to replace by open circuited, because internal resistance of ideal current source is infinite, and infinite resistance means open circuit. So if I apply these modifications to the original circuit, I will get circuit like this, having resistances R1, R2. Remember, we have opened RL, leaving behind two terminals A and B, through which we have to find out RTH, or you can say RN. So sometimes I may say it's RTH, but the procedure of RTH and RN finding is same. So I will write here RTH is same as RN. In this case, I will get Rn as R1 parallel R2, which is multiplication of two resistances divided by addition of them. So Rn we have found out. Third step is drawing Norton's equivalent circuit. Let's go back to the theorem once again. What it's saying, you can replace the circuit to an equivalent circuit with just a single current source and a parallel resistance. So the Norton's equivalent circuit will be like this: a current source with which we are having a parallel resistance. Current source is In, and parallel resistance is Rn, and these are the points A and B. How we are going to use Norton's equivalent circuit to find out IL, that we will see in next step. For that, I need to connect load resistance to the Norton's equivalent circuit, and our job is to get current flowing through it. It's a standard problem of a current divider rule. So while calculation of IL, we need to use current divider rule only. So by current divider rule, I will get IL, which is nothing but the resistance which is connected parallel to RL is Rn, divided by addition of these two resistances, multiplying total current supply, which is In. So every time while calculating IL, we are going to use this formula, which is current divider rule. So here we have seen how Norton's theorem can be applied to a problem, which is a simple problem we have taken in order to get IL. Now one more thing we want to develop, and that is relationship of Thevenin's and Norton's equivalent circuit. So actually what I am doing over here now, I will consider Thevenin's equivalent circuit. As per the theorem, I will have circuit like this. So here a Thevenin's voltage VTH, Thevenin's resistance RTH, A and B point as it is. Now if you see properly, it's nothing but a voltage source. Since it is having a resistance in parallel with it, which we consider as an internal resistance of this voltage source, so it is practical voltage source. Let's see its counterpart, which is Norton's equivalent circuit. Norton's equivalent circuit will have a current source, and parallel to it we will have a resistance. So current value is IN, which we call as a Norton's current, and this is Norton's resistance RN, A and B point as it is. Now if you see properly, I can relate this to a current source. This current source is having a resistance across it, which I can consider as internal resistance. So ultimately it is practical current source. Now thing is that these two circuits are linked to one another. How? I can convert this practical voltage source into a practical current source. So if I have a practical voltage source, which is a Thevenin's equivalent circuit, I can get its equivalent current source, which will be Norton's equivalent circuit, and the relationship is IN equal to VTH divided by RTH, and RN will be same as RTH. So what I have done over here, I have convert voltage source to current source. Voltage to current source conversion. Now next, suppose I know practical current source, I can get a equivalent voltage source, which is a Thevenin's equivalent circuit, and for that VTH is calculated, IN multiplied by RN, and RTH will be same as RN. What is this? If I know Norton's equivalent circuit, I can get equivalent Thevenin's circuit. So here it is current to voltage source conversion. So this is a relationship between Thevenin's and Norton's equivalent circuit. In subsequent videos, we will solve numericals based on Norton's theorem. Thank you.